In this video, we'll solve one more problem. Determine Vc of t in the following circuit. So here we have two independent sources. One is 10 u of t and another one is 1 milli. So this voltage source is active only when t is greater than 0. Okay. And Vc of t is voltage across the capacitor, that you have to determine. Okay. So this one more reference circuit I have drawn here. So that is for converting a capacitor from time domain to complex S domain. Okay. So that for reference I have pasted here. Okay. So how we can solve this one? First, let us calculate Vc of 0 minus, because we need that value. So Vc of 0 minus. So at t equal to 0 minus, this source is inactive. That means it is 0 volt. And how we can represent a 0 volt? Short circuit. So then what is the voltage across this capacitor? Then in the circuit, you will have a 25k in parallel with 5 microfarad, and it is in parallel with 100k, and all are supplied by this current source 1 milliampere. So you want to find Vc of 0 minus. Effectively, this circuit will be 25k, and you have capacitor and current source and one more resistor 100k. So you want to calculate voltage across this. This is nothing but the current multiplied by equivalent resistor. So that is, current is 1 milli and equivalent resistor is 25k parallel 100k. I think if you simplify, so this value will be equal to 20 volt. This is 20 volt. Okay. Now for t greater than 0, what is the equivalent circuit? T greater than 0, this 10 volt is present, 10 volt source is present. So we can write like this, a 10 volt source, and you have a 25k resistor here, and capacitor, one milli ampere current source, and you have 100k, and this one is 5 micro. Okay, we see it across this one. And now, this circuit, actually we can directly convert this circuit into complex S domain, but we can simplify, because one current source we have already here. I can convert this voltage source in series with the resistance. I can convert this into a current source in parallel with the resistor. That will be easy for the analysis. That is not a mandatory step, but we can perform so that equation what we get later will be a simpler one. Okay. So how we can convert source transformation I have to do. So source transformation, if you do, this will be a current source in parallel with the series parallel resistance. That is, that value will be 25k, and you have a capacitor here and resistor. This is 5. Now you have one more component. This is 5 micro, 1 milli, 100k, 20k, and this value of this current source will be from source transformation. So it will be V by R. So that is 10 by 25K. Okay, so that V by R, if you calculate, you take it to the numerator, that will be 10 milli by 25. So 10 milli by 25 is, again, 25 0. So if you calculate this one, this will be 0.4 milli. 0.4 milli will get, because 25 that 0, then you put 0, so 25 4 is 100, so 0.4 milli. So this value will be 0.4 milli. Okay, now this circuit you have to transform into complex S domain. Okay, so complex S domain, how you can transfer this one? So first one, a current source and this current source, I can club these two because they are pointing the same direction. I can add these two, that becomes 1.4 milli. So that in S domain, so in S domain it is 1.4 milli by S, that is the S domain. Then you have a resistance here, 25k, that will not change. That 25k and this 100k also will not change. That also I can club these two, so they are in parallel, so I can directly write that is 20k. I can directly write that one, that will not change. Now pending is only this capacitor I have to replace. So for that, how I can replace a capacitor? So capacitor, you just see that this one, I have two options: either an impedance in parallel with the current source or impedance in series with the voltage source. In the particular example, I think the second option is better. So impedance in parallel with the capacitor. So what is that direction of the current source? It will be opposite to I of S, opposite to I of S, or towards plus sign of the Vs. So that sign is the positive, arrow mark should be that side, and magnitude is CV of 0 minus, CV of 0 minus. So in this, we will add one impedance. This value will be 1 by SC. So S, you know, C is capacitance value is 5. So I think I will write S like this, S into C, 5U, 1 by SC. And you have a current source pointing towards up, and its value will be CV of 0 minus. So C value we know that is 5 micro, and V of 0 minus we had calculated, that is 20. So if you multiply this one, 25 is a 100 micro, 100 micro is the current source. So this is the frequency domain equivalent of this circuit. Okay, what we did, I will repeat. So 10 volt and 25k, we using source transformation, we have converted into 0.4 milli and 25k, and this we kept as it is. But 25k and 100k, they are in parallel, so 20k. And you have two current source, one is 0.4, another one is 1, that you can add, make it a single 1.4 milli. Then we will convert into S domain, so 1.4 by S will come, because we are discussing circuit analysis only for t greater than 0, so it should be multiplied by U of t, so that's why this by S. 20k, why we are getting, 25k parallel with 100k, so 20k. And capacitance I have replaced by impedance, it is 1 by SC, 1 by S into C, capacitance value is 5 micro. And a current source, its value C, V of 0 minus, capacitance is 5 micro, V of 0 is 0 minus is 20. Okay, so this is the circuit. We have to solve for V of S. V of S is this, is that is V of S. So you apply KCL at top node, KCL at top node. So if you apply KCL here, so we have two current source, I think here, one is 1.4 milli entering by S, and one more is 100 micro. So 100 micro, I can write 0.1 milli, 0.1 milli equal to two leaving current. One is current passing through this resistor, another one is current passing through this capacitor. So that is V of S divided by 20K plus this is the impedance now. So current passing through this is voltage divided by impedance. So V of S divided by 5U. So if you simplify, this will be 1.4 milli plus 0.1 milli and S divided by S. Then you have this side, you take V of S outside, then remaining 1 plus 0.1 S divided by 20K. Okay, so you will get this expression V of S equal to, you do the simplification, so I will directly write here, you do the simplification, it is 28 plus 2S divided by S into 1 plus 0.1S. Yes, this you will get. Again, you multiply it by 10, so this will be 280 plus 20S divided by S into 10 plus S you will get. So that using partial fraction you can simplify, but before you can split into two terms here. So that is nothing but 280 divided by S into 10 plus S, and you have one more 20 divided by 10 plus S. So use partial fraction. So this will be A by S plus B by 10 plus S plus 20 by 10 plus S. So that if you use partial fraction expansion, and you will get value here 28 by S, and this will be minus 28 by 100 plus S, sorry, 10 plus S plus 20 divided by 10 plus S. So final expression what you get is 28 by S minus 8 by 10 plus S. Now you take inverse Laplace transform, that is VC of T is 28 U of T minus 8 into U of T and e power minus 10 T you will get. Okay, so this is the solution.